Today we are going to talk about the next phylum and the last phylum, phylum Echinodermata. Phylum Echinodermata. This term, how it is derived? Echinus means spiny. Derma means skin. Therefore, their body surface shows the spines, spiny nature. We'll see the general characters. This is an advanced phylum. In invertebrates, Echinodermata is an advanced phylum. They are deuterostomes with radial body. We'll see the general characters here. The very important and most important general character here is the all or marine. All or marine. Very, very important MCQ. That means here they are present in the seawater, marine. No echinoderm you find in the freshwater. So freshwater echinoderms are absent. Important MCQ. All are marine. Here they are radially symmetrical pentamerous radial under radial symmetry, they are radially symmetrical under this pentamerous radial symmetry. The body is having 5 arms and their symmetry here is a pentamerous radial symmetry. All are marine, a very important character. Next, body is covered with the spines, and these spines are supported by ossicles. Supported by the ossicle. So beneath the, that means their body skin is thick. Their body surface is covered with the surface covered with thick skin. And on the surface of the skin, you find the spines. And spines are supported by ossicles. Here, ossicle is mesodermal. This is a mesodermal ossicles. Mesodermal in origin. See, the term whenever we come across ossicles means is a hard substance, which is made up of calcium carbonate. So, ossicle is mesodermal in origin. With the help of these ossicles only, it supports the spines. Spines comes out from the surface of the skin. Next important concept here is, here they are the, already I told that they are the deuterostomes here. That means, here they are deuterostomes Dittostomes. That means here Dittostomes coelomate. They have the coelom, which coelomate means here enterocoelomate. They are Dittostome and enterocoelomate. Enterocoelomate. Here there is no need to tell you that Dittostomes, they are nothing but formation of anus first, followed by the formation of mouth, Dittostomes. Enterocoelomate is an advanced coelom. So here they are enterocoelomate, therefore we can say enterocoelomate non-caudate. They are the enterocoelomate non-caudate, because under caudate also we come across the Dittostomes. So in that way you can say that all echinoderms are enterocoelomate non-caudates. This is one important concept. Here the body is covered with, or the body is covered with the spines, already we discussed. And you find a very important character here, that a unique character, a very important character here is having water vascular system, otherwise we call as ambulacral system, which is unique in the kingdom Animalia. What is the function of water vascular system here means, it serves the function of capturing of food and transport of food. This is one function. Second function, respiration. And one more function here is the locomotion. So these are the three important functions of the water vascular system, otherwise called as ambulacral system, which is very specific to echinodermata. And all are marine. This is another important specific feature. Because all are marine, we already studied in the beginning classes, that is exclusively marine. And having sexual reproduction means, you have to remember, it is of Ctenophora. In Ctenophora, sexual reproduction and all are marine. Here also all are marine. These two phylums you must remember. Other phylums you find marine as well as freshwater terrestrial, but here all are marine. Okay, this is the important characteristic feature of echinoderma, water vascular system and ambulacral system. Next important feature here is presence of an important structure called as pedicel area. What is pedicel area? Here pedicel area is just like a scissors. It is present in between spines. So here it has got a jaw, and the function of pedicel area is to clean the surface of the body. That means to clean the debris that are deposited on the surface of the body with the help of pedicel area. And not only that, it is even it helps in defense also, defense in function. So pedicel area, again this is a unique characteristic feature in echinodermata. We will see the next two characters here, other characters. the other characters here is one more, madreporite. See, this madreporite you find on aboral surface. Aboral surface. What is the function of madreporite means? This is for entry of water. Here madreporite is a opening. It's a opening through which the entry of water takes place. This opening is meant for the entry of water, madreporite. This you find on the aboral surface in case of like starfish. Madreporite is also a unique feature. See, pedicellaria, water vascular system, ambulacral system, pedicellaria, madreporite. These are all the unique characteristic feature of phylum Echinodermata. Then here we are talking about all the general characters. When we take up the classification, there we will discuss the specific characters, madreporite. Next we will talk about the other characters, such as here you find as far as circulatory system is concerned. Here circulatory system is concerned, it's a open type of circulatory system. Here heart is absent. So what is present here means blood vessels poorly develop. And as far as nervous system is concerned, okay, before that we will talk about the respiratory system. Under the respiratory system, what are the structure? Respiration is performed by the papulae, then dermal branchiae, and dermal branchiae and cloacal respiratory tree in case of sea cucumbers. Respiratory system. Then we will discuss the other system here. Excretion by the simple diffusion. Excretory organs are absent here. Excretory organs are absent, or we can say excretory systems are absent. It is performed by simple diffusion. Then we'll talk about the nervous system. Under the nervous system it is also poorly developed. Here brain is absent. Therefore we can say echinoderms are brainless and heartless animals. Brain is absent. And sensory structure poorly developed. When brain is absent, then sensory structures also poorly developed. Then a very important feature here is what you call sexes are separate. Hence we say it's a dioecious. Next, the important characteristic feature here is, next we will discuss here an important phenomenon, high power of regeneration. Again, an important bit here. high power of regeneration. See, high power of regeneration, just recall in other phylum, previous phylums, where we have taken example of Planaria, Platyhelminthes. There also you find high power of regeneration. Here also high power of regeneration. You may get the MCQs on such type of concept, like which of the following have a high power of regeneration, means examples will be given. Whatever the members of this Echinodermata, yes, having high power of regeneration, and even Planaria, that is in Platyhelminthes Planaria, even Hydra also has got power of regeneration. Here high power of regeneration. An important phenomenon called as autotomy. Autotomy. This is very important. What is this autotomy? Auto means self. Tome means to cut. That means here, for example, you take starfish. Starfish, when it first of all, starfish is a good predator. Apart from that, even it will escape from other predators. Here, whenever a starfish get captured by any predator, what will happen? In any one of the arm will hold by the other predator, that arm will get detached. That means one of the arm will get detached. It escape by detaching its own arm. Later on, whatever the body parts that has been lost, and mean to say that here arm, that arm will be once again regenerated. That means here Echinoderm has got a high power of regeneration, and at the same time it shows the autotomy. Autotomy, that means the last part can regenerate. So see, autotomy is nothing but detaching any part of its body. Like for example, here you can see there are certain echinoderms, when a predator comes, they throw out certain visceral organs, and later on that visceral organs will be regained. So this phenomenon generally we call as autotomy. So autotomy is a very important feature that you come across in phylum Echinodermata. So autotomy means to cut their body parts by themselves. That autotomy means to cut or detached their body parts by themselves, so that the lost body parts will be regenerated. Such type of phenomenon we call as a autotomy. Already I told that sexes are separate here, and you cannot differentiate the sexual dimorphism. Here no sexual dimorphism. No sexual dimorphism. Already I explained you the definition of sexual dimorphism. Identifying the sex, either male or female, based on the morphological feature we call as a sexual dimorphism. You cannot identify those animals, which animal is male, which animal is female, you cannot identify. So here, though they are separate, male is separate, female is separate usually, and no sexual dimorphism is exhibited. Then development includes larva. You find in this phylum Echinodermata, you find many larvas. That we'll discuss under the classification. You need to remember different types of larva you find. But a hypothetical larva that you need to remember is a dipleurula larva. Dipleurula larva. This is a hypothetical larva. But again, under the classes, we will specifically mention the different larvas under different classes. So these are the few important characteristic feature of Echinodermata. See, here we'll recall first what are the unique features that you come across in Echinodermata means. Number one, when it comes to the habitat, I already told you they are all are marine. This is the number one point to be remembered. And here, second thing is, though they are bilateral during the larval stages, this point to be noted. That means here, larva shows bilateral symmetrical. They are the bilateral symmetry. Larva bilateral symmetry. Adults are pentamerous radial symmetry. So these are the important point. Adult shows a pentamerous radial symmetry. During larval stages, they are bilateral symmetry. I already told that symmetry will be decided at the time of embryonic development. Hence, they comes under the bilateral symmetry. But when it comes to adult, you have to remember pentamerous radial symmetry. This is one point to be remembered. They are the enterostelomate and they are the deuterostomes. They are deuterostomes. And what are the other unique feature means? The unique feature is here water vascular system or ambulocral system, which shows this ambulocral system has got a lot of functions here already told. And it has got tube feeds and suckers. These help during the locomotion. And here water vascular system, madreporite, pedicellaria, madreporite, these are all the unique terms that you come across in phylum Echinodermata. And autotomy and high power of regeneration. These are the very, very frequently asked MCQs on these concepts. Now we'll talk about what you call, we'll go ahead with the, yes, as far as examples under classification, we will discuss those examples. Now we'll talk about the classification. We'll take, starfishes. Common example, you can take sea feather, starfishes, then feather star, then, brittle star, all these examples we'll discuss now. Now, we'll discuss now about the classification of Echinodermata. So, this phylum Echinodermata divides into or classified into two subphylum as Palmetozoa and Elytherozoa. See, subphylum Palmetozoa includes only one class. What is that class? Means here, Crinoidea. It includes only one class, Crinoidea. Whereas Elytherozoa, subphylum Elytherozoa, these further divide into, this we'll discuss in detail. That is, here it divides into four classes. Astroidea, then Ophiroidea, then Echinoidea, and Holothuroidea. These are the four classes that we'll discuss separately. Elytheroidea. First, we'll talk about the Palmetozoa, Crinoidea. See, they are sessile. General characters of Crinoidea. They are sessile and most primitive type. Sessile means they will not show movement here. And some are with a stalk. With the stalk, that means their body has got a structure to which they are sessile. This will get attached to the substratum. They will not show movement with stalk, and some are without stalk. So here, Crinoidea includes. There are certain important characteristic feature here absent. The most important thing here is why we kept this Crinoidea under Echinodermata. A unique feature, just recall, I said that ambulacral system. Here you find ambulacral system. Here is open. Usually it is closed. Except in Astraidea and Crinoidea, this is an open system. Madreporite and certain other characteristic feature like pedicellaria are absent here. This Crinoidea includes and very important thing here is the body, here spines, you don't find the here spines. Spines are also absent. Spines are absent. See, spines are the characteristic feature of the Echinodermata. Here spines are absent. So spines here, madreporite, pedicellaria, spines are all these absent. But here you can see that ambulacral system is open. Suckers here, tube feet without sucker. Without sucker. These are the primitive characteristic feature. Here both mouth and anus is present on oral surface. Some more characteristic feature. We'll discuss each and every here characters of these classes. First, we'll complete this one. And few characters here. You can see that arms are biramous. Biramous. Already I told that means. Let's suppose this is a arm. Biramous means when it divides, when it bifurcates like this, when we say this we call as a biramous. So arms are biramous with the pinnules. What is the function of this pinnule means? To capture prey. These are the structures. These are the some few characters that you have to remember. And here, development includes the larva. Development includes larva. What is the name of that larva? Means Dolioleria larva. So, in case of sea feather. Here the larva here is, you have to remember the larva name as pentacrinoid larva. This pentacrinoid larva in the sea feather. Now, what are the examples of this Crinoidea? Examples. Examples, you can take Neometra, then here you can say sea lilies, we say Tylocrinus. So here, see these pentacranial larva is nothing but the larva of Neometra. So Neometra, we can say it's a instead of sea feather, you say feather star. In case of feather star, so this is a feather star is nothing but this is a common name. Feather star. The common name of Neometra is a feather star. The larva of Neometra is a pentacranoid larva, and of course this pentacranoid larva is a sessile with the stalk. It develop into usually we have given the name of the larva here Dolio Laria larva. So this develop in the sessile along with the stalk. Such type of larva we call as a pentacranoid larva in case of Neometra, nothing but feather stalk. Then Tylocrinus. Tylocrinus is a sea lily, commonly called as sea lily. Sea lily with a cirrus or cirrhi. Cirrus is a structure that help in attachment to the substratum. Tylocrinus and Bathycrinus. One more example, Bathycrinus. Bathycrinus is, once again, this is a sea lily. Sea lily without cirrhi. Without cirrhi. So, these are the examples under the class Crinoidea and few important characteristic feature. Now we'll move forward with the next subphylum, Elytro. Here Palmatozoa we discuss. Under Palmatozoa subphylum only one class is included, that we call as the Crinoidea. We'll go ahead with the next subphylum, that is Elytrozoa. Elytrozoa, the next is subphylum. Subphylum 2. What is that? Elytrozoa. Elytrozoa. Here, Elytrozoa means they are. What are the general characteristics? They are free moving. That means they do not attach. They do not attach to substratum. Here you find ambulacral system. Ambulacral system open. No, closed. It is of closed except in Astroidea. In Astroidea. The general characters of the subphylum Elytrozoa. And as usual, madreporite. Here, madreporite is present. And here, these two important characters. They are free moving without attachment and ambulatory system. In almost sea, we have four classes here. All four classes except, that means in three classes you find a closed ambulacral system except in Astroidea. This you need to remember. Now we'll see what are the classes that we come across. These are the general characters. Under the general characters here, first we'll take up class 1. What is that class? Here Astroidea. Class Astroidea. We'll see what are the characters here. Astroidea, here arms are not demarcated. Arms are not demarcated. Here it includes starfishes. Under examples, we can take here starfish, Asterias. starfish, the most common example. Arms are not demarcated. That means if once you take starfish, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 arms having a madreporite. Arms are, I said that arms are not demarcated. That means demarcated, demarcated with the central disc. Let's suppose this is a central disc. It is not demarcated. That means here arms are rigid. It's not flexible. And you find here what you call an ambulacral system like this. And through this, you know, here the water circulate into the ambulacral system. So this is a madreporite. These are five arms. They are the arms. See, on the surface of the body, you find the spines here. Hence, we call as echinodermata spines. And of course, what are the other characters here? Pedicellaria is present with two jaw. What is pedicellaria? Pedicellaria, that means it is present in between the spines. Let's suppose this is one spine, this is another spine. You find in between the spine like this. Here the structure will be like this. This is a pedicellaria. I will enlarge this image. Pedicellaria is like this. This is a pedicellaria. So I already told that pedicellaria is having important functions of cleaning the debris on the surface of the skin. It even protection in nature. It is seen in between the spines here. In case of like starfishes, usually the pedicellaria is two jaw here. Pedicellaria is two jaw. And ambulacral system, here we need to talk about the ambulacral system. Ambulacral system. Ambulacral system here is open. Open type. It's open, and ambulacral system includes. Ambulacral system includes what you call two feet with the sucker. 2 feet with the sucker. If you want me to, so if you want to know that. I am drawing here like this. 2 feet means it will be like this. So this will be the 2 feet. What is the function of 2 feet? Means the water flows inside and circulate, and here the pressure changes in the 2 feet that helps in the locomotion. That is a function of the 2 feet you find in the ambulacral system. 2 feet are present with the suckers. Most important point, arms are not demarcated. It is not demarcated with these are the arms. Arms are not demarcated means shows a clear distinguish. That means you cannot find these arms with the central body. It get attached to the central disc. There is no clear demarcation of the arms. Hence, arms are rigid here. Since arms are rigid, that's the reason here you find that pedicellaria is present, and if any deposition takes place, any debris Then this pedicellaria will clean those debris from time to time, right? And here, what is the important, other important character means Astrodia. Under the Astrodia, you have to remember the larva. What is the larva of starfishes means is a bipinnaria larva. Bipinnaria larva. Important. So larvas of every class you need to remember, bipinnaria larva. Every class has got a different larva here. So these are the few important characteristic feature of Astrodia. Then what are the other examples that you take? Here you can take Asterias as a common, we say is a starfish. Then Pentaceras. These are the few important characteristic feature of Astrodia. As far as other general characters is applicable to this Astrodia, like respiration is performed by the dermal papillae or dermal, we say branchiae. This is common in the Astrodia. Okay, and madreporate on dorsal side. This you can see, madreporate on dorsal side. So, and you can take one more example as Astropecton. Astropecton. So these are the starfishes. So all starfishes include under the Astrodia. There is no need to tell you that Aster means here the name Aster. Aster means star shape. So Eidos means form. In that form they appear, star shape. Hence the name starfishes. Next we will talk about the next class, Ophiridia. The next class is a Ophiridia class 2 here. Ophiridia. Here the name Ophiors. Ophir means serpent like. That means idea means Eidos means form. That means they show the lashing movement, tail-like movement. Lashing movement means tail-like, snake tail. How the snake tail will move in that, that movement we say is a lashing movement. Hence the name Ophiridia. Here arms are well demarcated with central disc. That means it clearly distinct here, like this. This is a central disc. Here, these are the arms. These are the arms. That means here, arms are flexible. In starfishes, it was rigid. Here, flexible and fragile. Fragile means easily breakable. No problem. If once it get breakable also, it has got a very important echinoderms having autotomy or high power of regeneration. Even if once it get detached means, again regeneration takes place. The last part will be regained once again. This is a central disc. You find what you call a well-defined. Here the arms can be easily demarcated. You can say this is the arms. In starfish also you find the arms, but they are rigid. They are not flexible like this. That is the reason here, you know, pedicellaria absent. Pedicellaria or absent. See, one important concept here, there is no required for the pedicellaria. When these arms are very easily flexible, there is no chances of deposition of the debris. So hence, basing on the function structure also correlate here. You don't find this pedicellaria structure in a Ophiridia. Pedicellaria absent. And ambulacral system, this is very important. Ambulacral system is closed. Now, remaining all three, we have to say umbilical system closed type only, except in Astraea, in case of Elytrozoa, phylum, subphylum, Elytrozoa. In subphylum, what you call Palmatozoa, it includes only one class, Crinoidea, where once again umbilical system there open. And here umbilical system is closed and 2 feet, here 2 feet without sucker, without sucker, pedicillary absent. These are the important characteristic feature. Next, what else you have to remember here is, these are the arms, flexible arms. Then the next important characteristic feature here is, these arms shows a lashing movement, hence the name Ophiroidea, serpentine like movement, flashing movement of the arms. Other important characteristic feature here is, next we will talk about the, discuss about the larva. Here larva important, from here onwards the larva name will be represented by the class name itself, Ophioplutus. This is the name of the larva. In case of Astraea bipinnaria, here Ophioplutus, name of the larva. These are the important characteristic feature of Ophiroidea. Examples, under examples we say, examples, sea star. Here Ophiothrix, one example. And another example, you can say Gorgonocephalus. See, under Gorgonocephalus, one characteristic feature you can remember, that here arms are branched. That means in some Ophiroidea, like Gorgonocephalus, where the arms are biramous, arms divide again into in the branch. It's a branched Gorgonocephalus. So these are the important, two important you can take examples. Here we say Ophiothrix is so larva Ophioplutus. Ophioplutus. Ophioplutus is the name of the larva. Yes, you can take. So one more thing here, you can take here madreporite on oral surface. See, under this subphylum, that means in Elytrozoa, usually the oral surface shows downward movement, downward size. It is present towards the down side. So Ophiothrix and Gorgonocephalus are the examples under the Ophiroidea. Now next we'll discuss the class 3 Echinoidea. See, commonly we refer this as a echinus. Here is means hedgehog form is if once we go to the other animals like hedgehog, a spiny anteater, so generally we call this hedgehog. So in that way the name has been given to this class. That means when we disturb, then it shows the spines on their surface of the body. So here this includes sea urchins, then sea dollars. We'll discuss first the character here. Here the body is oval in shape, ovoid. body is ovoid and arms are absent. Arms are absent. Then here loose spiny, loose spine, spiny ossicles. Here the spines are loosely arranged. Spines are loosely arranged. So spines are loosely arranged, and here calcareous ossicles unite to form. That means the calcareous ossicles that are present in the body unite to form a test. We say even corona or case, different terminology, to protect the body. Since here arms are not present, the body is ovoid, or even you can take discoid also. And one more important character here is here water vascular system, or simply I can call ambulacral system. Ambulacral system is closed. Is it closed? Here 2 feet here. 2 feet Beer's suckers. Next. And one more important character here is here pedicel area is three-jawed. And here madreporite and anus. Anus is present on same side, or oral side, oral surface. Next. Next important character here is very, very important here. Here a very important in sea urchins. This is a very important character. In sea urchin, you find Aristotle lantern. Very important MCQ. Aristotle lantern, what is this? This is a phyjaw, masticatory organ found in buccal cavity. What is the function means here for the mastication of the food? In sea urchin, Aristotle lantern is present, but absent in heart urchin. In heart urchin, this is an important character. What is the larva you find here? Again, same class name, Echinopleutus. Echinopleutus is a larva of Echinoidea. Now, what are the examples? As I told here, we take Echinus. Echinus, common name, sea urchin. Then another example, Echinocardium. This is heart urchin. Then Echinodiscus. This is sand dollar. Sea urchins, Echinus, Echinocardium, heart urchin, Echinodiscus, sand dollars. These are the examples under the class Echinoidea. Next we'll talk about the last class, that is Holothuria. Before that, here madreporate and NS is present, you take aboral instead of that. Here you take aboral surface. Aboral surface. See, first of all, you should understand what is oral and aboral. Let's suppose if once I consider, okay, let me consider this is animal. This surface will be the, you know, wherever the mouth is there, besides the oral surface. Opposite to that surface, dorsal surface, besides the aboral surface. So here, aboral surface, madreporate and NS both are present on the aboral surface. This is all about your echinoid here. Okay, we cannot discuss and all those. Now, holothuridia. Class 4 here. Holothuridia. Here, holothuridia means, here the word holothurian means water polyp. See here, don't get confused with the water polyp. There is one more term. Freshwater polyp means it, you are referring to what you call hydra, cnidarians. There, hydra we call as a common name, freshwater polyp. Here, we are not using that word. We are not using freshwater. Only we are using the word here, water polyps. So, for the holothuridians. Why we say these holothuridians are water polyp means, here the body is elongated here. You see here, body is elongated. And with a oro and aboral axis. Oral axis, wherever the mouth is there, we say is a oral axis. Aboral means opposite to that. Aboral axis. Oral and aboral. And it includes all sea cucumbers. You find sea cucumbers having an elongated body structure. And here pedicellaria and arms are absent here. This is important. So, and skin leathery. Leathery means here coriaceous. Coriaceous. Coriaceous, and here you can see that with the loose spicules, the dermis is with the loose spicules. So here ambulacral system closed, except in Astridia, that means in starfishes is open, remaining closed. And here the mouth is surrounded with the retractile tentacles, and this retracted tentacles is nothing but it's a tube feed. Here tube feed is modified, and what is the function of tentacles means capturing the prey for feeding purpose. Here for feeding purpose. And apart from that, you find a pair of respiratory tree in the cloaca. Therefore we say is a cloacal respiratory tree. The function here is respiration is one of the organ you find in the holothuridia. So these are the important characteristic feature. And larva, here development includes a larva. What is the name of the larva means? Here auricularia larva. Auricularia larva. So you need to remember all the larvas, make a list of the larvas of all the phylums and classes, very important. Auricularia larva. And examples, what examples we take? Holothuria. Holothuria we call as a sea cucumber. Then Thion and Synapta. These are the three examples under Holothuridia. Hope you must have understood Echinodermata, both characters as well as classification. As far as need is concerned, go through the NCERT lines where a small, very little information has been given on these Echinodermata. Go through those lines, and for your extra information, you have to refer the state syllabus. So, with this, we have completed the Echinodermata. In our next class, we are going to talk about the hemichordata. It is a link between the chordates and non-chordates. In your next class, we'll talk about the next phylum, that is Hemichordata. So, with Echinodermata, we have completed Kingdom Animalia 1 or Animal Kingdom 1, which includes all these phylums. So, class is dispersed.